Children?
Yes.
Yes. How are you all?
Good.
Where is Brother Kumar?
What?
Sleeping?
Okay.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. There was a rich man. He is a miser. Very stingy person. Can I tell you again? Kanje. Yeah. He's very rich, and he had around 300,000 cash in his hand, $300,000 in his hand. His doctor said, "You are going to die within a week." He had a lot of possessions. Now he called his close friends, the doctor, one lawyer, and one pastor. He called them and said, "I'm going to give $100,000 to each of you." To the doctor, $100,000, to the lawyer, $100,000, and to the pastor. And he said, "When I am gone, in my coffin, you have to put this money under my body. I want to take it with me." So all of them agreed. So within a week he died. And the funeral went on, everything is over. Now the doctor, the lawyer, and the pastor joined together, and they started asking one another, "What you have done with the money? Did you put it?" So the doctor said, "I have to confess. See, I have so many bills pending, and I have some money needed for my hospital. So I invested 50,000 in my hospital. 50,000 I put into this." So the pastor said, "Yeah, I have also a confession to make. See, I am building a church. The church needed money. So I took only 50,000 for the church, and 50,000 I put into the coffin." So the lawyer came. He said, "You guys, you don't know what you have done." He said, "You have to put 100,000 in the coffin." So they asked, "What did you do?" He said, "I put the money in the bank, wrote a check for him, and put the check in his coffin for 100,000. You understood?
Yes. That's a lot.
So he can cash it when he go there. Jesus gave a parable like this. One man, he was a steward, what do you call it? So he is the caretaker of the money. And one day somebody complained about the caretaker that he is stealing money. So the master called him that he wants account from him. So before coming to the master, he called all the people to whom he has given the loan. He said, "How much you have taken? 100,000? Okay, write it 50,000. And like that, every debtor he called and wrote it down half off. So that he thought when he leaves the job, outside when he goes, these people will give them back something. So the master came to know about it and he commended that man. Not because he is righteous, because of his wisdom. He said, "The people of this world are going to be more cunning and wicked than you people who are my children. So don't follow their trail. You have to be honest." This morning, I'm going to share it. Sunday class. Is there a Sunday class? Is there a class? What does it mean? Your son. Okay. Yes.